Moving ahead now to Silverman Helps tonight, a shopping trip that ends with a surprise, a visit by police.
Watch it, buddy.
No.
Oh, hey.
No.
Don't you bite me.
Those dogs were the reason that Jack and Howard McGee were at Walmart on November the 28th of last year. They were buying a baby gate to prevent the dogs from running upstairs in their house. Well, they didn't buy the baby gate, and they left Walmart. And that afternoon, Howard went to work as a correctional officer when he got a very disturbing call
from our brother on four saying that the policeman came to the door and we were being accused by Walmart of theft.
What'd she ask you, for example?
Asked me, did I steal a baby gate?
Did you steal a baby gate?
Yeah, and a video camera.
And a video camera.
Right. Then I show her the receipt of a baby gate.
Mm-hmm.
Like where I got it. Which, at Canadian Tire.
So the baby thing was, that was okay. But how about the video camera? Where did that come from? Did she say?
I have no idea.
I was quite upset about it. Of course, because we didn't do anything. And I had asked my supervisor if I could leave work to clear this up, which I did, and I went to meet the police officer when she was finishing her shift that evening at 7, and she was busy and said she'd have to view the videotape in the morning and come and see me. And she viewed the tape that Saturday morning and came around 11 a.m., and of course it wasn't us, and very apologetic in that, and told us that we should be writing a letter to Walmart.
Howard's letter to the store went unanswered, so he called Walmart's head office.
And I sent them a fax saying, you know, that Mr. Silverman will probably be helping me with this. All of a sudden, Mr. Pelche was calling me saying, there's a letter in the mail to you. And it's been 2 months, and I've never received such a letter.
I'd gather that it was a little embarrassing.
Yeah, it was embarrassing enough to speak over the phone in front of my peers at work about such a situation. And at least they could give a written apology to people.
We contacted Walmart, and they sent Howard two letters and $200 in gift certificates. And they told us that at no time did Walmart accuse Mr. McGee of a crime, nor did Walmart advise the police to contact him. But it was Walmart who called the police and gave them the McGee's license number. And it says here, please accept our sincerest regret for any embarrassment you felt as a result of the police constable contacting you the way she did. Well, I suppose that's the closest you're going to get.
That's right. Well, thank you for your help, Mr. Silverman.
It's a pleasure. I'm Peter Silverman for City Pulse.
Got a problem? You need help? Contact Silverman Helps, 299 Queen Street West, M5B2Z5.